Boolean logical operators are used for testing logical conditions. There is a Boolean type in C++, and it's called bool. And so we'll create a couple of variables here. A will be true, and B will be false. And we can print these values using printf and treating them as if they were integers. And when I build and run this, you'll notice that I get 1 for A because true is 1 and false is 0, so B will be false. And in fact, if I were to assign a different value to A, it still will print as 1 because it's a Boolean type and any non-zero value is true and true is 1 in the Boolean type. The Boolean type is generally implemented as the smallest possible size of an integer, which is usually 8 bits on most systems. So if I try to print the size of it, size is %zd, and use the size of operator on A, and I'll multiply it by 8 to get bits, and we'll build and run this. You see size is 8 bits. So on this machine with this compiler, a Boolean variable is 8 bits, and it may or may not be different on your computer. But generally speaking, try to implement it as the smallest possible size of an integer. Now, C++ has 3 Boolean logical operators. And so I can say if A and B, so the double ampersand is a logical and, then I puts true. And otherwise, we'll puts false. When I build and run, we notice that it says false because the expression A and B is not true. So the result is false. So there's and, there's or, which is 2 vertical bars. And if I build and run that, we get true because A or B is true. Because A is true, if I just say A, it's true. There's a not operator, which is an exclamation point or a bang. And if I build and run that, it says false. Now, Boolean operators, the operands to the operators can be the result of any logical expression. So I can say 42 is greater than 5 and B, and this will be false because B is false. And if I say and A, I'll get true because A is true. And so both sides of the logical and expression are true. 42 is greater than 5, that's true, and A is true. Or I can combine them, I can say not A, and now it's false. The AND and OR operations perform what's called a short-circuiting evaluation, and this is useful to know in circumstances where the evaluation of an operand is significant. And so if I say A or B like this, the B will never be evaluated because A is true, and it doesn't matter whether B is true because with the OR expression, the result is going to be the same either way. So when I build and run this, this is true, and B is never actually evaluated. And so the same is true if I say B and A. Because B is false, it doesn't matter if A is true or not, so it's never evaluated. Some people do notice that there's no Boolean exclusive OR operator. An XOR operator would evaluate true if one and only one of the two operators was true. There's several reasons for this omission. According to Dennis Ritchie, one of the original designers of the C language, the XOR operator would be superfluous, and because it cannot be short-circuited, it would not work like the AND and the OR operators. The XOR is effectively the same as the not equals. If I say B is not equal to A, that's only going to be true if one of them is true and one of them is false, which is the same as the XOR condition. So I can evaluate that and I get true. Or for circumstances where the operands may not be of Boolean type, you can use the not operator in front of each of the operands, and that will force them into a Boolean condition, and you get the same result. So the logical operators are simple, they're straightforward, they operate on logical conditions, and they may be used for logically combining conditions.